Now an iTeam exclusive, a funding fight affecting dozens of autistic children and parents desperate for help.
Nebraska's Autism Action Partnership pulled millions of dollars meant to help kick off a state program for critical care.
iTeam investigator Adrian Whitsett is live with a story you're seeing new at 10.
Tonight I spoke with one of the board members who voted to pull that funding. Dr. Bruce Bueller tells me they worked on the legislation for 4 years and that Health and Human Services made last-minute changes as to how they'd help autistic children.
Woodwork, paintings, expressions of creativity from a young man still learning to express himself.
I hope I don't freeze.
Good.
For years, Will Lipinski struggled to find his voice. But with the help of countless consultants and hundreds of thousands of dollars, he's making progress against autism.
We started this therapy and he's able to have, he has language now, he has, he has academics, he's got leisure skills, and he's happy.
It's something the Autism Action Partnership of Nebraska wanted for other autistic children.
This was an intent to get these children in at the earliest of age, get them started. This was 0 to 5, and the intent was to maximize the number of children who would have the best outcome, become functional citizens.
But last week, Dr. Bruce Bueller and the partnership board pulled $2.5 million given by a private donor to be used over the next 5 years. Other funding would come from tobacco settlements and Medicaid, but it all hinged on that donation. Bueller says they ran into problems with the Department of Health and Human Services.
They were unable to go with that plan. They wanted to cut the number in half, use money for other purposes, including administrative fees.
In a statement, HHS says, "We're disappointed that the private donor has decided not to fund this. We're ready to implement this as the statute requires. We've received the Medicaid autism waiver, drafted rules and regulations, and hired staff." Dr. Bruce Bueller says the partnership's willing to start over.
We would like to go back and start the process with the governor and with the Department of Health and Human Services and relook at the issue and rethink it together and do something quickly.
That's what the Lipinski family wishes as well.
There's a sense of desperation out there for families, and I just hope and pray it gets resolved as soon as possible.
The Autism Action Partnership tells me Nebraska ranks 49th in the country in autism services, and if families can't get help early, the burden will then fall on the school system and then taxpayers if children can't grow to be functional adults. Reporting live, Adrian Whitsett, KETV News Watch 7.